the Boston Bruins. He's coming off a shutout. Second career shutout, first this spring. Two career playoff shutouts, one this spring for 41-year-old Wayne Roleson. Best and second best in goals against. Best and second best in save percentage. And if there is a player to watch in this game, who would it be?
I'm going to say Steve Downey, Doc. He doesn't have any points in this series. His line with Dominic Moore and Sean Bergenheim have been terrific. All players having 10-plus points. Bergenheim with 8 goals. Downey's a key. If he can get on the board offensively, Tampa's got a great shot this afternoon.
Dana Terrell is in the lineup for Tampa. Blair Jones is out. That's the only change for the Lightning. No changes for the Bruins. And it is Patrice Bergeron's unit that begins with Mark Recchi and Brad Marchand. Marchand trying to step by. Did not have the puck. The sure-handed Nate Thompson clears it back down, and it will go for an icing touch-up. Time for Inside the Glass with Joe Micheletti.
Mike, Patrice Bergeron hadn't played in nearly 2 weeks. Of course, he got back in the lineup in Game 3, and what a start he had. There was some talk and I think probably a little concern as to how he would play after missing that amount of time. He said he was going to be very cautious. He told me that yesterday, but he got right into it. The physical part of the game, he jumped on. He played nearly 20 minutes in this game and was tremendous on faceoff.
Yeah, took 28 of the 65 faceoffs in the entire game. And to Joe's point, 64% for Patrice Bergeron.
When he goes against Vinny LeCavalier, he is coming off having won 10 of 14 against him. That is a matchup that probably will happen. The line that scored early for Boston in game number 3 is out there now. Nathan Horton, Milan Lucic, as well as David Krejci. Rifled right back ahead, and it went off Horton and back in. Dwayne Roleson sets it up behind. These two goaltenders have been tremendous. 10 goals scored by both teams in 3 games. But it was more to the expectations of both coaches last game, the defensive battle that was won by the Bruins 2-0.
Yeah, who's going to out-defend who and who's going to make the one mistake, and ended up being for Tampa 69 seconds into the game.
Purcell laid it to the corner. Jostling LeCavalier and Boychuk. Led on now to Purcell, steps in front, trying to get the shot away, wasn't allowed. Laid on back across, Eric Brewer the shot. It kicked off, and another try on the wrap by LeCavalier was shut off by Tim Thomas. Charging back ahead with this one, laying it back on as Recchi, able to take the check and keep charging on. Centered one in front, and it rattled around. Poked on back in again as Marchand. Drawing it on across, and Recchi got it there. Held by Barron. Shovel shot went wide. Looked like it might have been a pass attempt for Marchand, but it's carried back up by Marty San Luis. University of Vermont product rolled it back in. Big Zdeno Chara hands it on. Reverse on back, but he couldn't get it to Chara, could Adam McQuaid. And so out of this scrum up the boards, it's carried back up by the Bruins and knifed away from Tyler Seguin and carried on by Kelly. But an offside is already in. Having been dragged there was Michael Ryder.
When we talk about team defense for both these teams, Marty St. Louis makes a beautiful little pass right under the stick of Patrice Bergeron. Left part of your screen, Brad Marchand. Look at the hustle here. Lifting up the stick and not allowing Teddy Purcell a good opportunity in a high-quality scoring area. But to take a look at it, see how low the Boston Bruins forwards were? Very close. Not a lot of room. The points are open.
Gagne to Malone. Malone tried to feed one in front. Canceled out by Char. And then he's banged to the boards and glass. And the glass still shaking a bit down there. Carried on back out. Zdeno Chara through the first 3 games with 9 hits registered. Sean Bergenheim with the most for the Lightning at 10. Here is Ryder, shoved off by Victor Hedman. Carried back up by Steven Stamkos, and that one blocked on back for Bruin possession and carried back by Seguin.
Well, you can already see what Tampa Bay is trying to do in this game. They talked yesterday about trying to get everyone back into their own zone a little bit deeper and come out of the zone as 5 players. They feel they'll be able to generate more scoring by playing that way.
Offside is called. Guy Boucher, the coach of the Lightning, mentioned to Joe and myself yesterday it was going to be deep versus deep. He felt deep in the defensive zone was where the game was going to be won or lost by either team.
Yeah, below the goal line, right? An area in behind the goaltenders, winning a battle, making a play, to Joe's point about coming out as 5-man units. And that first pass is such an important part of that. Had a chance to talk to Brett Clark, defenseman for Tampa Bay, as he was walking into the building this morning, and that was one of the things he mentioned, that defenseman got to make a better decision, but a first good pass out of the zone will allow the Tampa Bay Lightning that freedom in the neutral zone, because this game, I thought, in game three was won by the Bruins because of their neutral zone play.
Here is Horton feeding one in front that rattled away from Krejci. Horton a shot, and that blocked back down again. Some tight defense being played by the Lightning as well. And then this one chipped out of play on a deflection, no penalty.
Now Michael Lundin with a good shot block there. Puck took a crazy carom off the glass, and that's why Nathan Horton was able to get to the puck and create a couple of opportunities there for himself.
And by the way, guys, that was the second consecutive shift that Le Cavalier was able to get on the ice without Zdeno Chara out there. But Boston won the faceoff, controlled the puck. That allowed them to get Chara back on the ice. And now the change by Tampa Bay. Le Cavalier's line comes off.
What is the threat, Joe, that Chara presents to anyone who's out there?
Everything, Doc. I mean, physically, he's so physically intimidating with the way he plays, but then defensively, such a smart player with the long reach, and as we saw last game, just played a conservative game. It was so effective.
It takes up space, a lot of it.
6'9", 255. He's not a mean-spirited sort of guy, though. Could you imagine if he were?
Thankfully.
Not all the time, though.
Here's Downey moving ahead with it now. Downey threw it across, and a shot by Bergenheim rattled in front off of Thomas. My goodness, a good combination there for the Lightning. Dragging his way through a lot of traffic is Lucic. Played it to the corner, was bumped by a pair, went down, back up, comes to the bench with his line mates for a change. Been some good hitting early in this one.
I was going to say, it's much more physical than the start of game three.
Remarkably, that one went through some waving sticks and can be floated along by Adam Hall. Picked up by Dominic Moore. Moore angled it on back for a hurried shot by Lundin that went wide. Bruins able to play it back out. Claude Julien was saying yesterday, it is a team, Boston, that is built to battle the boards. We like it when there's a battle in the corner or along the boards because our team is constructed to win those. To the back, Lundin a shot. Off of Thomas and wide! Laid back ahead and carried on, weaving his way along is Peverly. Peverly has Campbell with him, steered one that was sort of a half-speeder and a little bit of trouble for Rollison on the cage. Sent to the back, drive by Ferris, ricocheted in front, was reached at, diving back is Rollison, and out of all that confusion, the puck emerges the other way. All right. Right back ahead, it comes off Campbell. Both goaltenders have had to make some scrambly plays here. There's been good hitting, no scoring as of yet. Past the 5-minute mark in elapsed time in the first period. Carrying it right back in is Brad Marchand, banned on the shot. Marchand again, set up Ferentz. Ferentz a shot, off escape. 5 in the frame for the Lightning. Losing a stick is Thompson. Can't regather it. Across for a shot. Oh, shrugged away by Rollison. And then held by Simone Gagné. Stabilized there for the floater back out by Brett Clark. Trouble for Bergeron. Racing back is Stamkos. Gains the zone. Shooting, and he got the glass.
Boy, does he have a quick release. Doesn't need a lot of room to be able to change that angle.
It's Purcell trying to walk out of the corner. Denied there. Sticky defense being played by the two teams that have the best defensive averages. Jabbed along behind, and Ferentz with a little more room this time. Floated one along that's driven right back to Purcell. Sets it up, San Luis a shot, and that one blocked away. Good block by Dennis Heidenberg.
What a play there by Hedman. Keep the play alive.
Well, the aggressive forecheck by both teams is causing some turnovers that's leading to those chances.
And Tampa has the edge big time. Physically got 8 hits.
Now Guy Boucher said that his team lacked energy last game, but I'll tell you what, they are on their toes in this one. They're off to a good start.
Left behind by Olin, drive, and that one deflected up high. Nathan Horton let that shot go. Taken out of the play, Eric Brewer. Lucic tried to flip one in front. Head on back to the point. Boychuk a shot, went wide, and watching for it coming off the boards was Rollison, and he's able to seal it up. 2 shots on goal apiece. Lots more in the stat department, but no score.
Losing weight clicked for me when I realized that Weight Watchers Online is for guys. All the guys, they think, do some crunches, that'll just make you thin right away. That just doesn't work. So with Weight Watchers Online, it teaches you about doing the right things when you're eating. There's something called a digital cooler. Grab some beer, maybe some chips, and you can stay on plan. I lost 57 pounds. I pick up a 55-pound weight, and I cannot believe that used to be right here.
Hurry, join for free today. Weight Watchers Online for men. Finally, losing weight clicks.
LensCrafters has the styles you love. At the LensCrafters Style Event, save up to 50% on eyeglasses and sunglasses made with your prescription. Hurry in. LensCrafters.
Right now, all over the country, Discover customers are getting 5% cash back bonus at home improvement stores. It pays to switch. It pays to Discover.
Hey, Crystal. We're going to head on into the interview.
What led to your decision to go with the Fusion?
I just keep going back to looks. It's a great looking car.
How do your coworkers feel about your Fusion?
They were the ones who were against Ford. They're like, they're a truck company. For the most part, I'm pretty sure I've changed almost everyone's mind.
Crystal, you seem pretty comfortable up there. Are you sure you haven't done this before?
I did 8th grade telecommunications class.
Let's take a look at the Ford Drive 1 update.
Oh, big hits. Marc-Andre Bergeron stepping up on David Krejci. An elbow call, clearly not an elbow. Krejci made a beautiful play on his last shift here to go from low to high. And again, with both teams being very good defensively, their wingers come way down. So the open ice is out at the blue line. Take a quick look, and once you move that puck, everybody else on the ice has to recognize it's going from low to high. Get to the front of the net.
Thrown in front by Chara and flexed back out by the right pad of Rolison. The hits so far are 7-3 Tampa Bay. They try to float it to the front, no luck. Taken along by Ryder and chipped further, hoping for Kelly, but did not get him. Instead, it's Olin. Help up the half boards from Nate Thompson. Puck left behind, Kelly couldn't reach, and it's sent on for Thompson to carry ahead. Anchorage, Alaska native, sent it past Caverly, took his own pass, backhanded one in front, they poke away at it, and hanging on is Thomas.
And a couple of pitchforks there by Tim Thomas as well. Tampa's making some good decisions in the neutral zone, which they did not do, and they get a fortunate bounce here. Thompson fouls it in. Look at Adam Hall, he goes harder than that, what I love what he does. He stops in front of the net, but watch Thomas with his stick. Gives him a shot, and then he loses his stick and ends up throwing the blocker right at him.
Well, for the last day and a half, we've heard nothing about the way Boston has played defensively, and as far as Tampa Bay, they were going to try and crowd the net. I mean, they're going to the net hard to try and generate some more scoring chances.
And the mindset has to be the players without the puck. You got to get there. You can't wait for the puck to be on its way. You have to be on your way while the puck is there. Give yourself an opportunity. It gives Tim Thomas or Dwayne Rolison something to think about.
Bergenheim threw one in front. It went off the stick of Downey to the corner after Dominic Moore getting glass and boards. And now the puck, Brad Marchand. Thrown off by Chara, and it careens back down. There'll be no icing here. Well, the Lightning talked about driving the net, and so the Bruins very easily were able to read the intentions of the Lightning, and they probably anticipated that anyway. Thomas is reacting himself in there. If they aren't going to stop play, I'm going to stop it myself and just throw in a few right.
Better be careful.
Here's Hedman shooting, and that one deflected wide, and it's off a high stick, and for that reason, play is stopped. Let's take a look at today's McDonald's I'm Loving It spotlight player, Martin San Luis. He's not the largest guy, but he's one of the most productive. 16 points in the playoffs.
I think Marty's actually looking at that monitor to Joe Micheletti's position of inside the glass. What's he taking a look at down there, Joe?
He's looking at himself right now. Then he turned away, said, that's enough of that. Now they call his name, and it's time for a shift.
Well, that brings up a point, Joe. Is it yelling a name? Is that what a coach does, or does he tap guys on the back? How does he know to go out there?
Well, I think it's a combination of both. With the crowd, when the crowd is loud, you've got to tap somebody on the shoulder to make sure that they get the message. In that case, it was just a yell from Guy Boucher.
Giveaway. Bergeron a shot on, diving in front of it was Daniel Paille, carried ahead by Peverly. He angles it back in and then takes a hit right near Joe.
You have to be aware, talking about the matchups, Joe was talking about Lecavalier versus Zdeno Chara. You have to be aware, there's too many men on the ice in game three for Tampa Bay.
Much better Lightning performance here in the first period than in game three. Forced along by Purcell, but grabbed and started right back ahead to the outside. It is carried on by Horton, and then he got a pass that is sent across to Krejci, led onto the back, and Boychuk a shot, and that deflected wide, came back onto Chara now. Chara rattled it around. Chara and Seichenberg have been out together a lot in this playoff, but right now it is Adam McQuaid as Chara is coming for a change, and that explains it.
And that's just kind of getting in between line shifts, and all it takes is that one shift where it's advantageous for a particular club. And take advantage of it.
Well, the other thing they're doing is that they're starting the shifts with one of them on the ice, and then depending if they win the faceoff and depending who's on the ice for Tampa Bay, they'll make a quick change.
Both Seidenberg and Chara played about 28 and a half minutes last game. Racing in for a shot was Paille, and that one was stopped by Rollison.
Beautiful play there by Rich Peverly. Throw it to an area and let Paille find it and create a good chance.
Well, there's an unsung hero for the Bruins in the latter part of the season and into these playoffs is Peverly. Does an awful lot that they really needed to have done when Bergeron could not play. Twisting along with this is Marc-Andre Bergeron. Got it ahead for Dominic Moore. The Harvard man brings it on and shoots one that's turned aside by Thomas and played by Downey. Downey spun one in front off Moore, covered by Thomas. They poke it loose, but not until the whistle is blown.
Marcy forgot to arm her home security system, but with new ADT Pulse solutions, she can do it right from her phone. When Gary travels, he can program his home to help save energy, which can help save money. And with secure video through ADT Pulse, Lisa can know when her daughter is home from school. Introducing ADT Pulse. Now manage and help protect your home from your phone or computer, plus save $250. Call or visit ADTPulse.com for a free in-home review.
To increase fuel efficiency, its profile is sculpted for optimal aerodynamics. It reduces wind resistance in an irresistible sort of way. The all-new Ford Focus, with up to 40 miles per gallon highway.
So at our company, we pay about the same, even though I'm a great driver and he's not so much.
Well, for a driver like you, I would recommend our new Snapshot discount. This little baby keeps track of your great driving habits so you can save money.
Amazing.
It's like an extra bonus savings.
He's my ride home.
How much can the Snapshot discount save you? Call or click today.
It might be hard to believe that the new Focus can virtually park itself. Until you actually see it park itself. The all-new Ford Focus with class-exclusive Active Park Assist.
Time now for Edward Jones FaceTime. Joe is with Lightning coach Guy Boucher.
Guy, your team looks much better in this game than they did last game. What are they doing differently?
Well, we felt last game we didn't have any energy. I don't know why, but I think we had a long trip back and late at night, and it took a lot out of us probably. And that second game was hard for us in that third period trying to catch up. So we had a lack of energy last game, but we got our legs back tonight.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
To give you an idea, the coach said he got home to bed at 5:30 a.m. Here's a drive that is directed wide as they were delayed about an hour and a half in their departure, let alone the 2.5 to 3 hours that it took to get down here.
Yeah, they had plane problems, some technical problems with their airplane, which is the reason for the delay.
What a handoff there. It's taken on by Ryder away from Marc-Andre Bergeron to the corner, helping out as Mike Lundin and dropping back further Simone Gagné. And it is laid back along but kept neatly by Kelly. Must play at center across to Ryder again. Shot total is low. 5 shots for the Lightning and 4 for the Boston Bruins. Skip to the corner where it can be spun further and worked to the outside all the way back by Sagan. Handed across by Kelly and a shot from the point deflected to the corner. Shot block total is getting up high here, particularly on the part of the Lightning. Nub behind now for Victor Hedman. 20-year-old filtered it on through, coming by as Chara. Punched it, but right into some traffic. Simone Gagné moves back up the wing with it. Dips the shoulder, but couldn't get by. Looked like the end of a shift for him. Meanwhile, it is dealt back along and off his stick. He's coming to the bench for a change with Malone. Meanwhile, it's sped ahead by Seidenberg, and that one ricocheted wide. No icing there as Hedman reverses into traffic. Bergeron score at the side of the net! And it's 1-0.
Well, Victor Hedman's going back for this puck, and what he's doing, stop it right here. He's reversing the puck back this way, and then the eventual goal scorer is over on the right part of your screen, Patrice Bergeron. Brett Clark overskates it, and Dwayne Rolison on his knees. But the misplay by Hedman to Clark, when you're reversing that, you got to make sure that there's only one guy and there's separation. But the puck took a bad bounce on Clark, and it ends up in the back of the net.
Doc, you mentioned it earlier. Remember what Guy Boucher told us yesterday? He said this series is going to turn into one that's not going to be played much in the neutral zone. It's going to be deep. That's a good example right there.
It is unassisted. The third of these playoffs for Bergeron and the lead to the Bruins. Guy Boucher said yesterday as well, dropping down 1-0 is not the end of the world. Two goals makes a huge difference, though, and will in this series. Jabbed around behind. Battled for there. Good ragging of the puck by Horton. Fed in front away from Lucic and started back ahead by Eric Brewer.
I don't think there's any question, though, that this game has a much better pace to it than the last game.
Well, you're right. Quick changes of possession, too, and lots of forecheck. That's why the Bruins had to make decisions quickly. It's also why the Lightning did, even though it was a bad one.
I think Tampa has the puck a lot more in this first period than they did in the last game.
This is carried ahead by Zdeno Chara. Shuffles it ahead and Paille in early, so has to reverse to center on a delayed offside that is wiped now as the Bruins had curled all the way out. Lug back across for a backhander by Bergenheim that's wide, brushed away from Downey. Chip back up the boards and the Bruins can start ahead in the person of Paille. Could not get through the checking that's inadvertent from the linesman. Followed through, though. And then it comes right on back to center where hustling ahead is Bergenheim trying to roll it through. Guided back to center by Kaberle. Turning with it now is Hedman and hands it on back to Bergeron. 6 3/4 minutes to go, first period, and another takeaway. And Campbell nudged one in front that was guided away by Rolison. Oh, goodness. Led on to the back and out to center where it is recoiled by Kaberle.
And again, that was Hedman, the 20-year-old defenseman, which is a little unusual because he's now has the reputation of someone that plays better the bigger the games they are. And he's had a couple of tough plays here in the early going.
This is a long for Ryder, and Ryder is able to step away through one that went off the linesman and wound up being a delayed offside that's carried ahead then. Going back on, but no luck for Tyrell. Meanwhile, brought back in by Kelly. And offside is called there. 5:59 to go, first period. Bergeron unassisted, 1-0 Boston.
Welcome, thanks for coming.
We're gonna head on into the interview.
Was fuel efficiency an important factor in buying this car?
Oh, definitely. As all my friends would tell you, I am one of the cheapest people you'll ever meet. And whenever I was filling out with gas before, I'd have a scowl on my face.
You seem very comfortable up there. Have you done this before?
No, I haven't. And I'm actually terrified right now.
This
May. The next featured $5 footlong of the month is the delicious Orchard Chicken Salad Sub. With taste-terrific chicken, sweet apples, crunch-alicious celery, tasty golden raisins, and a tangy cranberry kick. All piled up on your favorite freshly baked bread. It's a bushel full of flavor, and it's joining our many $5 footlong favorites for a limited time only. So hurry in to sink your teeth into the Orchard Chicken Salad, the featured $5 footlong of May. Subway, eat fresh.
Ovechkin moving up ice. Score!
The ninth goal of the game for Alex Ovechkin.
A triple hat trick!
What would you call this?
I would call it the best trick.
Ovech trick.
He's going for the Ovech trick.
And there it is. If it's happening in hockey, it's on NHL Game Center Live. Real-time stats, highlights, and over 1,000 live games.
Another Ovech trick!
Don't just rule the ice, rule the air. NHL Game Center Live, only from Verizon.
The NHL Stanley Cup playoffs on NBC are brought to you by Ford. Drive one. And by Warner Brothers Pictures, The Hangover Part 2 in theaters May 26th.
Well, that last shift for Victor Hedman, trying to make a pass, loses it, and there's Gregory Campbell, does a nice job on that back pressure. To give Hedman credit, he never gave up on the play, tied up the stick of Campbell, and a weak attempt there. Good recovery there by Victor Hedman.
Fear is a great motivator, isn't it? Luck back on. Gagne a shot, and that one went wide and angled on for the carry back out by Milan Lucic. The big winger hands it across. Krejci across now for the connection that fails, but then eventually is gotten from Horton to Lucic. Now back on for Krejci again. Then back to Chara! Wide with the shot as gliding in front for the tip was Nathan Horton.
Good play there by Eric Brewer to come out and deny that real good opportunity.
Chara again. It rattled around in front. Sweeping at it was Rolison. But it bounced wide and help came. Play back on Gagne. Stood into by Chara. Jabbed it right back. There has been talk about neutral zone defensive systems in this series. Do you guys notice that they're being employed here in this game early or not?
Well, right here you're going to see it for Tampa Bay. No pressure. They got five guys back into what a 1-3-1, and that's what you got to do. You got to dump it in and get pressure, support. Can't try to skate through two and three players.
I think there was more talk about that 1-3-1 than we've seen in this series.
An injured referee at one end and a save by Tim Thomas at the other. That is Dan O'Halloran shaken up on that last play. There are standby officials in case an injury is so bad that the official cannot continue.
There's Patrice Bergeron and Danny O'Halloran. Nowhere to hide there, just trying to get out of the way and collides with Bergeron.
He's in a tremendous amount of pain. Stephen Walcom, who refereed here in game number three, is the backup referee. He will be watching this game in the referee locker room, watching on a monitor with his gear on and ready to go just in case. Just nowhere to go for Dan O'Halloran, and that's it. As his legs got clipped, his skates got clipped, he went down. He looked like he was really holding on to that, or that left shoulder of his was dragging.
Well, we're going to go back to the goal, and Victor Hedman's the guy that's going back, so there's a couple things to watch. Watch his head. He just looks this way. He doesn't realize that there's another forechecker on his heel. He only looks to his right. If he looks both ways, right at the end he did, but he saw the pressure coming. And he would have just been better suited to keep that puck on his forehand and then fire the puck all the way around the boards on his strength.
Oh, and LeCavalier jabbed one that was sort of a half-speeder and swatted away by Thomas. Here is St. Louis out there. The guns are out right now for the Lightning. That one could not be held by Hedman, so he'll have to retreat to play. Dan O'Halloran has remained in. Not to our surprise at all. The man is incredibly tough and has taken a lot of pain in his life, including a drive-by shooting in one of the major cities when he was riding in a car, just random, and he survived that. and then has built a great career as a referee working the last Olympics in Vancouver. On now comes Marchand. Fed one that was stiffly off of Bergeron and lobbed back ahead by Purcell. Carried on by St. Louis and back in where McQuaid will go to get it.
Tampa caught a break there because I think Marchand was looking for Tyler Seguin, who had just jumped on the ice and was wide open down those right wing boards.
Oh, what a change off the boards, and it's held by Rolison. My goodness.
That's why you stay home if you're a goaltender, if the pucks are in the glass. If he goes to try to help out, this puck ends up right in the net. And goaltenders know their boards, they know the glass, but when it's around like that, stay home. And Rolison does a miraculous job there.
It's a great save, isn't it?
Absolutely.
We pinpoint moments in a game when a great save can turn things. Usually it involves a player from the other team standing right in front, though. This is carried back ahead by Michael Ryder. Fans it out a little bit. Jab one in front. Score! Michael Ryder! And it's 2-0.
Now this has been a game of turnovers with the aggressive forechecking. And Bergeron turned this one over for Tampa.
What a play by Chris Kelly. Patrice Bergeron is stepping in, but watch the stick of that man right there. Lead with your stick. He forces a turnover. Now it's a two-on-one. Ryder goes forehand, backhand, off the stick of Mike Lundin, in behind Wayne Rolison, who thought the pass was going all the way over.
It almost looked like Ryder got one more piece of it up in the air. Did he get it here?
I don't think so, John.
No, missed it.
Just barely. Get a good look here off the right skate, or excuse me, the left skate of Dwayne Rolison.
They haven't posted it on the big board, but you see it on yours. Take it to the bank. It's 2-0. Carried ahead now by Hall. Big drive by Tyrell, and another one is deflected up high to the corner glass. And be dealt with there by the Bruin defender, is in deep to work that, and punch it around behind was Horton.
A shot blocked there by Johnny Boychuk off of Terrell.
Nathan Horton is out there with Gregory Campbell right now. That one swatted away by Ferentz, carried back on by Thompson. Nudge from behind by Campbell. Thompson wanting to drive to the net, spins with it now, laid it back, hit and a shot! And it's blocked down by Paye, and lost to the corner by Peverly. Rubbed on back, and it's Hedman yet again, and that one cut off yet again by the Bruins. Shots are not getting through. Both teams pride themselves on having five guys in the frame, being pretty tight to their goaltender. This carried back along now by Paye. Paye laid it on a cross. A shot went whistling wide. Came back one for Chara, and that one is butted back out. Striding for it was Malone. He and Chara tumble down to the ice. Seidenberg smoked out there by Stamkos, who tries to get back. And we get a penalty coming up.
Be holding the stick. Dennis Seidenberg on Steven Stamkos. Yeah, right there, you see him kind of pinch in the arm and there, the hand around. And referee Dan O'Halloran makes the call. Doesn't allow Stamkos to get free right away. A little bit of eye contact there with Stamkos and the referee.
That's a good job by Stamkos, using his speed to get in quickly on Seidenberg and not allow him to make a play.
And that play all started because of that battle you mentioned, Doc, with Chara and Malone, but Malone got the puck in deep.
This is a Bud Light power play. Here we go. Stamkos giving it up for the carry-on by Bergeron, and a shot, he scores! Bergeron, short-handed, unassisted. Three unassisted goals in the first period for Boston.
Maybe a goaltending change here for Guy Boucher. You have to try to change the momentum at some point. And not a good goal to give up if you're Dwayne Rolison. Bad decision there by Steven Stamkos. The shot from 35 feet out, right between the legs of Dwayne Rolison.
How about the quickness on the release, Edzo? He gets a piece of it, but this has been a Boston Bruins team that's continued to force turnovers. And here's what you just talked about. Now, and I agree with you, Edzo. Something's got to change here, even if it's momentum, even if he comes back with them in the second period,
exactly.
which you never know.
Yeah, I was thinking more along those lines. And I want to watch Guy Boucher if he talks to Dwayne Roloson. And I like what Mike Smith's doing here. He's just buying a little bit of time. They got a power play. They're not in a hurry. I want to see if Guy Boucher talks to Dwayne Roloson on the bench at all. Kind of leaned
not
over
much.
A little bit. Yeah, as soon as Roloson was going by, there was no eye contact at all. And be interesting to see if he would go back to Dwayne Roloson at the start of the second period. So if you're Tampa Bay, you gave him a gift. Now you still have a power play. Lots of time. Minute and 55. You even it out if you could get one on the power play. Makes it difficult, but the mindset is right now the Bruins have it going. They're everywhere right now and taking advantage of some opportunities.
Well, we saw in game three, the Bruins are 5-1 in the playoffs on the road, and they've taken this crowd out of it again.
We may have someone using a timeout. It seems like we've gotten a delay here unusual.
I don't think so, Doug. I don't. Bought some time there with the change of the goaltender.
Just verifying the game clock, we are told. Meanwhile, Dwayne Roloson is back at the bench area. Three unassisted goals. Bergeron with a pair. This last one shorthanded. He now leads the Bruins in playoff points with 14.
Well, we saw him come back in game number three, and I thought Bergeron played a remarkable game in game number three. Did not get any points in that game. Was a plus one on the night. Just under 20 minutes of ice time. Killed penalties. Won faceoffs. Was extremely visible. And now you add to that a couple of goals in this game. And again, he's been better here in the first period than he was last game.
And I think the slotting aspect of when Patrice Bergeron is in the lineup, Joe, to your point, everybody else plays the amount of minutes that they need. So David Krejci isn't killing penalties. Mark Recchi isn't killing penalties. So when you have Patrice Bergeron back in the lineup, everybody's slotted and, you know, it's a little bit more comfortable. Everybody wants more ice time. But when you have your best all-around player in the lineup, everybody just slotted into positions they're supposed to play, and everything just works a little bit more smoothly, and ice time is, you know, where it should be.
Chris Kelly, 23 and white out there for the Bruins, and he has been given an assist, and appropriately so, on the second goal, the Ryder goal. Bergeron's two goals are unassisted, carried on by Stamkos on this power play. And you noticed earlier, this is the second playoff appearance in the lifetime of Mike Smith. San Luis with a shot that went wide, struck the back of the cage. The first one was very successful. Eight saves out of eight in 19 minutes. And his team was trailing 6-3. They made it close at 6-5 with him in the cage.
Another good play there by Chris Kelly. Winning a battle, and Inchara supporting and able to clear it down, and wholesale changes for the Bruins.
Right. He's been one of those players that was acquired by Peter Chiarelli, the GM, that can play in a lot of different roles for you. Penalty killer, win faceoff, give you some offense when called upon.
Mike Smith takes that pass from San Luis, who comes to the bench for a change in the final minute of the first period. A stunner for the local fans here. They'll number about 21,000 today, maybe a little more than that. Gagne chased off by Paille. He has been effective, hasn't he? Paille chips this out and goes to the bench for a change.
And everywhere.
Well, he never gives up on a play. He's an excellent skater. Stops, starts, especially the penalty killing, which he takes a lot of pride in.
Oh, getting a piece of that shot up the wing from Malone was Thomas. And this one cleared back down.
Tampa Bay finally getting a better entry, and Steven Stamkos used the speed, pulled up, and was able to hit Malone down those left wing boards.
It is Malone first. Second was Boychuk. They collide. It spun on back and walked across by Brett Clark. Handed on to Downing. Twisted on back to Clark. Has to circle away. Buzzbomb was Marchand, and a shot is sealed up by Thomas through a screen.
Well, a game of mistakes. And if you can capitalize, good things are going to happen. A botch reverse play by Victor Hedman. Patrice Bergeron. Marc-Andre Bergeron stepping up. Great play there by Chris Kelly. Michael Ryder, a little help off the stick of Mike Lundin. And then the giveaway by Steven Stamkos to Patrice Bergeron. The afternoon for now is done for Dwayne Roloson. An
That's exactly what the game is. It's a game of mistakes. And again, this game, a much better pace, much more aggressive forechecking by both teams. It's led to a lot of those turnovers. And Edzo, I think again in this game, Boston in the neutral zone was great.
Oh, what a backhander there, played by Malone into Thomas. And the horn sounds, but the action does not stop. The referees are talking to the players to try and get them to break this up. I overheard the one referee say, I've got one guy. So there will be at least one penalty out of this.
You got Bergeron and Peverly going at it right now.
Game 77 of the playoffs. If these are majors, and we may need to wait until the intermission to find out, it will be the 11th set of fighting majors. When the Bruins went to the final in 1988, in the first round only, there were 50. Things have changed since then. Coming up in the Pizza Hut intermission report, Mike Milbury and Liam McHugh with their favorite plays from our first period. Plus, we'll hear from the Bruins' Tim Thomas. That's ahead on the Pizza Hut intermission report. Bergeron at 11:47. Ryder from Kelly at 16:34. Bergeron shorthanded at 17:56. The shots in the period, 10-9 in favor of the Lightning. Liam and Mike are next.
Delta having the hip surgery, but he said, I didn't know how good he would be, but he is just... You know, the way he's come back, he said the one thing you can't forget about Tim Thomas is his competitive nature. And he said because he's got that, you never know what he's going to give you.
Power play is on for the Boston Bruins. A false start on this first faceoff. Fighting majors to Peverly and Marc-Andre Bergeron. A roughing minor and a misconduct. So for 12 minutes, we were given at the start of the day the player to watch, and later we'll be given the horse to watch in the Preakness by Eddie Olczyk. Downey was the one, but he remains out of commission for these Lightning here for a little over half the period. So the Bruins with their first power play of this game. Overall in the series, they are 2-for-13. 4 for their last 22. That one is drilled in off the linesman and kicked back around where it can be played back up by Nate Thompson. Hustles ahead, is watched by Caverley, puts on the brakes, and throws one that had to be blocked off by Thomas. Thompson comes to the bench. Had to be a tough decision to decide to go with the same goaltender you finished with or make that change back that you had talked about late in the first inning.
Yeah, I'm sure thought a lot about it towards the end of the period, that being Guy Boucher.
Here's Bergeron denied nicely with a flick of the wrist from Seidenberg. Another play in front, guided on by Seidenberg. And so the Bruins have been forced back twice already on this penalty kill by the Lightning and make that 3. Thomas connects across, and it is Zdeno Chara there, the owner of the 106-mile-an-hour slap shot. Weaving his way along, shakes it back in. It rattled on around and can be played on further in a strange set of bounces, but laid back out again.
Pardon me, Doc. That hit Dan O'Halloran, the referee. Oh, he's hit. He's had quite the game thus far, hasn't he?
Linesmen have tried to get out of the way of some plays along the blue line and have had it kick off them a couple of times in the first period, too. But battled for at the back of the cage. Comes all the way around to Bergeron. Patrice Bergeron of the Bruins laid one up the boards that did come to Ryder. Across to Chara. Lobbed it back to the corner. Bergeron connected back along. Sagan gave it to the back. Led back to him by Ryder. Shot fought off by Smith. Rebound carried along by Mark Recchi. Nudged on further for the pass back to Ryder. Ryder dealt it across. One time shot went whistling wide. Oh, can that man ever bring it? And then Ryder another shot. And Sagan was there really letting the best that he had go. And we get a whistle and a stoppage of play. And I may have seen 18. That is 19, Sagan. Sure enough. from this distance. I don't know how guys call horse races, but the sleep numbers of a 9 and an 8, well, we're getting into more detail than anyone wants.
That's what you call a saddle cloth you're looking at, Doc.
When are you going to grace us with your pick for the Preakness?
Soon, soon.
Now, keep in mind that he has correctly told all of us on NBC two of the last four horses that have won the Kentucky Derby. 50%, not bad.
Eddie, I don't know if this is going to change your mind, but Peter Chiarelli, in talking about Dennis Seidenberg, his defenseman has played so many minutes, last night he called him a horse. So I'm not sure if that's going to change anything for you
No. That's a compliment in my world.
Full strength action, Marchand could not get by Hedman. Knifed on further, and it is shaken right into the traffic of the referee. Spun free then by Purcell.
I think if you're Tampa, you build off of that penalty kill. That was a huge opportunity for the Boston Bruins to go up four. Now you can use that as a building block. You're not going to get all three in one. Chip. Well, let's just chip away. That needs to be the mindset of Tampa Bay Lightning.
Sent down was San Luis. Fans thought there should be a penalty. Meanwhile, this is Luck back on. And Caverly a drive that's flexed away by the waffle board of Smith. Chipped on further and darting to that now is Lucic. The big man throws one in front and a good cancellation by Lundin. Fed back to McQuaid in the shot. And that ricocheted to the corner. We're going to get a stoppage of play as two players are down. Meanwhile, let's go inside the glass with Joe Micheletti.
Thank you, Mike. We talked at the beginning of the game about the importance of having Patrice Bergeron back in the lineup for Boston and how important he was in game number three. But how about this game? He took his game up to a whole new level. Here's an unassisted goal to get Boston going. And then this one was the shorthanded goal after he stole the puck. And so for Patrice Bergeron, back playing at as high a level as he's played all season long.
Seidenberg gave it on across. Lobbed to the front and that booted away. Claude Julien told us yesterday that there was a question, of course, about how he was physically. But he asked him, how are you mentally? And he said, I'm fine. Here's Stamkos' shot. Followed through, and then Thomas roughed up. Meanwhile, the puck kicked loose right in front. Thomas chasing, going over to the Bruins benches. There'll be a penalty coming up. Sent across, and Chara shot. Oh, and a flopping move there by Mike Smith. Thomas came charging out, and I thought he was chasing Ryan Malone, but I forgot Ron Hextall has retired.
I believe this will be goaltender interference guy. He made a remarkable save with his left skate, but I believe the call will be goaltender interference. Here's Thomas well out. And there you see the contact. There's the save. Now this was goaltender interference, but
look how far out Tim Thomas is.
Yeah, it looked like Tim Thomas was the one that initiated the contact.
Gagne was looking for the puck and not realizing. I mean, you have to know, because Tim Thomas is out on top of that blue paint a lot, so you have to recognize that. But at some point, that ice is as much Tim Thomas as it is Simon Gagne.
You know, I talked to Terry Gregson last night, who is the director of officiating in the National Hockey League, and we spent a lot of time talking about goaltender interference. And a big question is, who does the initiating? And to me, that time it was Tim Thomas.
Thrown in front, and that one went off Caverly. Chased back to the corner, and Adam Hall was stepped into by Seidenberg.
And one thing to make mention, we're talking about the goaltending change, Mike Smith in for Dwayne Roloson. Mike Smith handles the puck as well as any goaltender in the National Hockey League. So you have to be aware, if you're the Boston Bruins, you can't give up on any play in the middle of a change, especially in the second period with the long change being away from your defensive zone.
Eddie, I talked to Doug Huda, who is the defensive coach for Boston, about that in between periods, and he said they're even going to make more of an effort to make sure that puck goes around the glass and they keep it away from Smith.
This played back across now and thrown in off the boards by Seidenberg. Well, given how the glass was bouncing earlier in the first period, those strange bounces that remarkably Roloson got, maybe the boards are better, or at least more reliable.
A little more true.
This is Seidenberg able to Bergenheim bringing this ahead. Watched there by Caverly, and a shot into the glove of Tim Thomas. Power play is sponsored by Bud Light. Gagne the goaltender interference penalty.
Tampa's had a couple of opportunities while shorthanded on these last two penalty kills, and easy pickings there for Tim Thomas. Remember a bad play in Bergenheim with eight goals. Was the right thing at firing it at the net. Look at Eric Brewer, the defenseman jumping in even while shorthanded. So the Bruins should expect the Tampa Bay Lightning to, unless they take chances this early, but sir, if the opportunity presents itself, I'm sure the defensemen have the green light to go ahead and try to make a 2-on-2 into a 3-on-2.
Defensive zone draw here for the Bruins. Bergeron crossing sticks repeatedly there, and it is taken by Chara. Joe was mentioning the goaltender interference calls. There have been 23 now in 77 games. Not one every three, but the Lightning have had 5, counting this one. That's the most of any team that's competed in the playoffs so far. Nudged on along now for Lucic off of Patrice Bergeron and back out. So just 10 seconds to go on the second kill of the period for the Lightning. Shoveled back in again by Chara. Away from the reach of Smith. Jab back further by Adam Hall. Laid on back to Chara. Cross. One-time drive by Boychuk is held by Smith.
Well, this last shoot in by Zdeno Chara. Stop it right here. Zdeno Chara is having it. He's going to shoot it around, but watch goaltender Mike Smith how early he anticipates his puck going around. I mean, if one time, if you want to keep a goaltender honest, if he's trying to get a lot of those pucks, don't be afraid to fire it right at the net one time. It'll keep him in his net. And Mike Smith's come out almost 100% of the time, even when the pucks have been in the glass. To your point, Doc, about that crazy carom a little bit earlier in the game, you got to be awfully sure when it's up in the glass. So if you're the Bruins, keep Mike Smith in that net and maybe shoot one on him, waste one on him.
So don't look at him, but just put it on goal.
That's it. Just, you know, make it look like you're going to go, you know, shoot it one way, but then actually come back against the grain.
Why does the name Raymond Bork come to mind right now? Used to score some, especially in the tiny Boston Garden.
He could bounce that puck whenever he wanted to. I remember a couple of times trailing him and seeing him just kind of turn the puck over on edge just a little bit and see the puck dipping and diving.
Stamkos threw one that pinballed right back for Peverly. Sends it ahead for the carry back up by Paye. Paye crisscrosses, drops to Peverly, holds, and then tried to work his way through. A nice back check there by San Luis, and it's reversed on for Matias Olin.
Peverly's got to shoot that puck. Paye did a nice job of isolation on that two-on-two opportunity to shoot it.
My goodness, that's turned into a lot of traffic there, and a back-ender score! It's Purcell, and it's 3-1. Maybe it's zapped into the ice.
A couple of things to watch. In behind the exchange, but eventually the puck will work itself out in the middle of a change for the Tampa Bay Lightning. Good hit there by Ryan Malone. Gagne with the pass and a forehand backhand by Teddy Purcell.
I think Zdeno Chara was surprised. He had pressure from both sides. And I agree with you, Eddie. He was able to, when he got the puck, there wasn't much he could do with it. Two players right on top of him. And then Teddy Purcell with a tremendous move going to his backhand. Here it is again. As McQuaid went out to block it, Purcell with a beautiful pull to the backhand and the quick shot. And that gets this crowd here in Tampa going.
In this situation, Tim Thomas gets the puck in behind the net. Well, he's got to recognize where the pressure is coming from. Move this puck right away. He waits for Zdeno Chara to almost skate into him. He has to see where the pressure is. And maybe he didn't think he could get it by the big guy while he was standing on the boards. But once you see a goaltender standing there too long and you got pressure coming from both sides, trouble usually happens. And what a great play. Forecheck by Malone, Gagne with the pass, and Purcell. Great patience, forehand, backhand, along the ice to beat the aggressive Tim Thomas.
Young man out of St. John's, Newfoundland, played a year at the University of Maine. Teddy Purcell has been splendid for these Lightning in the regular season and the playoffs. Is back to get this now as Hedman.
And he was a player they spent a lot of time with in the first half. They didn't think that his intensity level on a regular basis was where it should be. So they worked with him to make sure he was more consistent with his game, and he's been much, much better since the second half.
Yeah, Guy Boucher told us the other day, did a lot of video work with Teddy Purcell.
Sagan the shot, deflected wide, chopped in front by Kelly and turned aside by Smith, who is now a +3 in his short stint. They scored 2 in front of him when he entered the game back in Boston, and one here. It's fed across. Here's Le Cavalier around behind, tries to tuck it in and can't. He's got it again, though. Onto the back to Olin. Fed it on across for the setup there. Pulled and shot. Score! Purcell to ensure order.
This puck back to the point, and look at the net presence, and Teddy Purcell again, but the play all started in the neutral zone. Michael Reiner went for the steal. That gave the Tampa Bay Lightning a 3-on-2,
and again Purcell, watch his patience, changes the angle, pulls it over to the side, gets Tim Thomas just to move just a little bit. And then the perfect shot up high. He didn't have much to shoot at, but he hit the spot.
Talk about the neutral zone play, Doc and Joe. Over the course of the last couple of games, it's gotten much better, really, for both teams.
Eddie, that was an odd man rush, as you mentioned, you pointed out there. They only had one Tampa Bay last game. That was a 4-on-4. That one nearly went in.
That was from Stamkos. And it's carried back ahead. We are in the midst of a Lightning surge here. Will not destroy our computers, but it might make the game even more interesting. Off the back of the cage, a penalty is coming up, and who do we have this time?
I think it's on Brad Marchand. Steven Stamkos was in behind the net.
The Lightning to the power play. Up a man, down a goal.
It is the newest.
Even newer.
Everything else is obsolete.
I just bought this one.
What the?
Brady?
Oh, whoa, wait. Oh, 4D TV? Stupid.
You got the wrong TV, silly head.
The new buyback program. You buy it now, we buy it back when the new thing comes out.
Losing weight clicked for me when I realized that Weight Watchers Online was for guys, too.
I'm like, it's not rainbows and lollipops.
After I read this beer cheat sheet, I knew what the difference was between a light beer and a dark beer as far as points go.
I use the grilling cheat sheet, drag it over onto the grill, and it gives you a point value.
This is a plan for men.
I lost 109 pounds.
Oh, man, you're on Weight Watchers Online. That's funny. And I go, really? I look a lot better than you right now.
Hurry, join for free today. Weight Watchers Online for men. Finally, losing weight clicks.
There is no way to avoid a ticket if you don't use your seatbelt. Cops are stepping up enforcement and looking for unbuckled drivers like never before. If you don't buckle up, you will get stuck with a ticket. Click it or ticket.
Well, there's a man in the box, Brad Marchand, power play chance for the Tampa Bay Lightning. Left part of your screen, look at Marchand. Comes in, looks like his hands are down, but his stick is up a little bit. And I think the referee saw the follow through. Actually thought that was a pretty good hockey hit.
I thought it was shoulder to chest.
The call is interference.
Well, then it doesn't make any difference what kind of hit.
Don't think you're right.
The puck was right under him.
Yeah, the puck wasn't there.
Lightning power play sponsored by Bud Light, and here we go with Olin connecting with San Luis off the boards to Gagne behind. Chara able to clear it back out.
And because of the TV timeout, that gave Stamkos an opportunity to rest and start this power play.
Purcell's stick is still blazing from 2 in 63 seconds. This is ripped back by Stamkos, protected by San Luis over to Le Cavalier. He's got Gagne near the net. Deals it to him. They change places. Little finesse pass. Trouble there. Lifted along, but right into Gagne. Stalemated by Seidenberg. Two aside right now. Led along, more tangle. Stripped away and eventually cleared back down by the Bruins again. 1:10 to go on the power play. Lightning trying to come up with the tying goal. Here's LeCavalier, fed it across, and it ricocheted free. Oh, and Stamkos was hit by Boychuk, who's able to lift it back out.
That was a bad change by the Boston defenseman, Zdeno Chara, that allowed that 3-on-1.
Saw some of that stick handling that Eddie mentioned about Mike Smith. This is carried on now by San Luis, able to slither it eventually out to Dominic Moore. Moore tries to drag in and does. He's got Malone near the front of the net. Shakes one back. Bergeron with it there. Marc-Andre gave it on a cross, and it's held there by Clark. Given back to Bergeron. He can bring it. So can Clark. And that one fought off in front. Big scramble there, but it's nubbed on. They can't clear out. For a shot, and that went off Boychuk. Along to Campbell, and he's able to lift it back down. 22 to go.
A great play there by Andrew Ferentz. Followed that puck and knocked it off the stick of Dominic Moore. It looked like he was going to have a wide open net.
Dragged along in traffic and fed back by Purcell. Poke great Bergeron. Purcell with it. Drips. Fed one on a cross. Held. Shot. Deflected. It went to the corner. Brett Clark peeled back in. This one is knifed out to center by Patrice Bergeron. Jab back in by Clark and hit a linesman and is carried onside and then lost to the front of the goal and guided away by Tim Thomas. What a crazy set of plays these are. Up the boards it comes. Hedman with it. Cleared one that ricocheted off Krejci, and galloping ahead with it is Marchand, fresh from the box. Fed on to Krejci moving in. Krejci pivots, shaken to the outside. Good defensive work done there by Gagne. Carried right back ahead by Dominic Moore. Moore lobbed it back in. Bergenheim battling there. Comes up with it. Scores!
Tim Thomas, a surge. It's all Tampa Bay right now. If you're Boston, how do you stop it? Doesn't look like they can right now.
Well, the aggressiveness of Tampa Bay on the forecheck. They're getting in on top of the Bruins defense before they have a chance to make a play. And for Bergenheim, goal number 9 of the playoffs. That leads everyone.
We heard Mike Milbury talk about it in the first intermission, of how aggressive Tampa Bay was in game one. When you're down 3-0, it's easy to abandon what got you here to this stage in the playoffs. A couple of huge penalty kills early in this period, let's not forget. They started the period shorthanded, then they took another penalty, they killed them both off, and look it, threes are wild in the second.
San Luis pinched it behind. Hedman up with it there. Leads it ahead. LeCavalier's pass came there. Chara forcing it further, though, as San Luis. Through the legs, LeCavalier screened off. Recchi in front, dueling there. My goodness, what offense here coming from the Lightning. Work back on. Bergeron slung one wide. Bounced on over to Mark Recchi. Chopped away from him by Lundin. Set up by San Luis. Motored right back ahead and carried on by Purcell. Led it across for a finesse move by LeCavalier that would have been pretty had it gone to San Luis. But Big Chara was in the way. Lugged on back by Patrice Bergeron. Sets up Chara. Save Smith. Rebound bounces all around. Smith reaching out trying to flex it away. And play is stopped.
Hand pass.
Nice little game, isn't it?
All different. That's why there are 5 new Civics. The next generation Civic. Only from Honda.
Hey Dave, we're out of Bud Light.
Oh, good thing I just downloaded this app.
Here we go.
sure sign of a good time. Just right taste of Bud Light. Here we go.
Nice app.
I gotta get a new phone.
Drivers who want to get the most out of their cars. It's Bridgestone or nothing.
Time now for Edward Jones FaceTime. Joe is with Bruins coach Claude Julien.
Claude, you had the lead and the momentum. What happened? What changed?
Well, obviously, when you look at the goals, miscommunication between our D and goaltender there, gave him a first easy goal. Again, we're starting to get caught with their stress guys here. We're getting them the space that they need, so got to tighten up a little bit here, Joe.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
There you see Thomas Caberle. John Bergenheim, his ninth goal of these playoffs. He is just now pulled into the lead ahead of Daniel Sedin of the very prolific Vancouver Canucks. Sedin with eight. This is a John Drew story, isn't it? Careless guided away. That's about a decade and a half, maybe more, with the Washington Capitals. You just don't expect big performance, and you get it. 14 goals in the regular season and 9 in 5 weeks of playoffs. Here's a chance in front, directed wide by Malone, and hopped on out to center where it's played by Eric Brewer.
A nice play there by Simon Gagné along the boards, and Tampa's got a lot more room in behind the Bruin defenseman.
Krejci too far for Horton, but he followed up and kept play going. Lucic stalemated, got it to Krejci, chipped it on across. Chara, drive, turned aside by Smith. Flicked along again off of Chara and corralled by Boychuk. Boychuk just places it back in. That one kicked around now for Brewer. Brewer and then Olin, and Olin nudged it on. Nice carry back out, and here's Bergenheim charging up the wing. Shooting one that went wide. Shift change on for the defense of the Lightning. Marc-Andre Bergeron plays that one along. It's taken now by Moore. His pad chipped in front. Bergenheim defended and whacked at there by Tara. Led to the back. Another shot, and that directed up high. Looked like it went off the mesh, and sure enough, it did. Want more hockey? The NHL Game Center Premium app gives you live radio broadcasts of every Stanley Cup playoff game, video highlights as well, and more right on your phone. That's exclusively from Verizon. Nice to hear organ music, people responding to it. Makes me feel not quite so elderly. Pardon me as I clap along here. Meanwhile, this is jab four on the half boards.
The lights just went out by the
way. They did, didn't they? Carried back on by LeCavalier. Moving up, fakes the shot. LeCavalier, bad angle shot is held by Tim Thomas.
Tampa holding the physical edge. 15-7. 6:42 left to go here in the second.
Now Tampa is starting to gain the blue line a little bit more with speed through the neutral zone. And this onslaught by Tampa has kind of caused these Bruins to back up a little bit, be a little bit more cautious. That's given Tampa more room.
This is grabbed by Purcell. That one flipped ahead and is grabbed off by Recchi, stashed on back for Bergeron. That's Patrice Bergeron of the Bruins. But then it's laid back out again by Clark. Stanley tried to play it through. Bergeron said no. Follow up by Clark again. And this one goes back in. There'll be no icing. 6:20 to go, second period. Boy, have things changed. Lightning with 10 shots this period. Bruins with 9. Those were the totals at the end of one. But the number of goals has changed markedly. 3 for Boston in the first. 3 in under 4 minutes for Tampa Bay here in the second.
Now there's Sean Bergenheim. Doc, you mentioned the kind of playoff he's having. He had 14 goals during the course of the regular season, and he made a major change prior to the playoffs starting. He changed stick companies. He uses this Bauer stick now. And the other thing he did, Eddie, and you can relate to this because you were an offensive player, he cut an inch off the top of his stick. So it's much lighter. He can handle the puck and pull it in away from forecheckers a little bit better. And boys, it had some sort of an effect on him, hasn't it?
Yeah, more psychologically, I think, anything else, Joe. And learned this a long time ago. It's not the stick.
No, it's not?
It's the sticky.
Why didn't you tell me that years ago? I could have used some of that advice.
And two cases of Bowers are headed to the Dubuque Fighting Saints, where Adam Micheletti is in charge of hockey operations. And they are ahead in the USHL playoff 2-1. Ahead with this now comes Bergenheim, shooting one, and that deflected wide, rattled all the way around. Playing the Green Bay Gamblers, they are, in the USHL playoffs. This has been across, Paye slid one in front, and it's spiked away by Smith. Ducking for some reason there was Dominic Moore, may have caught a stick. Meanwhile, play at center, and it is carried on by Adam McQuaid, and McQuaid just bashes it back in. So they are doing what you instructed the Bruins to do, and that is play the harder round back in there. This is sled back for McQuaid. Shovel shot, blocked right back. Reflex action kept it nicely alive for Boston, but too many lightning, and the bounce favored them. It's cleared on out for the control of Ferris. Quickly right back ahead now to Krejci. Krejci delaying, through one that's nicely back-checked away and thrown to the corner by Moore. Played to the outside. Lucic gave it across. Kept alive by Ferentz. Ferentz motors in and threw one in front. Oh, and having a reach at that one was Horton. Fed to the back. McQuaid with it. Moves in. Fakes the drive. Shovels it across. Lucic there. Fires. It's deflected up high and out of play. Getting in the way of it was Olin. A 3-3 tie. Late second period.
Another win for the Flyers. They're now 18-0 on the season. Hardell in front. Score! The streak continues.
Will these guys ever lose another game?
So what's up with the facial hair?
It's a little itchy, but it works.
Did that just go off his beard?
If it's happening in hockey, it's on NHL Game Center Live, only on Verizon. Live radio, real-time stats, and up to 40 live games a week.
It all comes down to this.
There it is! The perfect season!
Don't just rule the ice, rule the air. Only from Verizon.
The Lemon. We've gotten a bad rap. We've become synonymous with dud, reject, flop, failure, bust, fiasco. Anything defective is a lemon. Never mind that people love to squeeze us and we're a favorite among aromatherapists. Introducing the McCafe Frozen Strawberry Lemonade from McDonald's. Now we're the bee's knees. We're tart and tangy with the sweet taste of strawberry. Oh yeah, how do you like me now? The simple joy of being a lemon. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Edmunds.com says that Lexus holds its value better than any other luxury brand. IntelliChoice proclaims that Lexus has the best overall value of any brand. And J.D. Power and Associates ranks Lexus the highest in customer satisfaction. No wonder more people have chosen Lexus over any other luxury brand 11 years in a row. See your Lexus dealer.
Well, coming up next, the Preakness Stakes presented by J.P. Morgan Chase. Next, right here on NBC, and that's Animal Kingdom.
Looking
towards history and the second jewel of the Triple Crown, the Kentucky Derby winner. Sorry to say, but I don't think he's going to get it done today.
Oh, really? Okay, who's your pick?
Sway Away, number 6. Garrett Gomez.
I'll be right back. Then you could pick against a horse that looked as nice as that.
Beautiful as that.
Oh, all right. Well, at any rate, off this offensive zone faceoff, this is Mike Smith, who has been out and is +3 in the game, +5 in the playoffs this year. A couple of replacement duties that have worked out well for him. Forced along now by Hedman. It is Ferentz putting on the brakes. Michael Ryder brings it on. Jabs it ahead and it spiked right back down, and that one reached in an offside as San Luis was in the zone early. 4:10 to go in the second and a 3-all tie.
Joe, we talked about it in game 3. The hot, warm temperatures here in Tampa this afternoon, up above 90 degrees. How does the ice look to you at ice level?
Yeah, you know what? It's actually held up really well. I kept an eye on it in game number 3 and even in this game as well. They've done a remarkable job to keep this ice at a level where these players can still make plays.
It looks good from up here. Not a lot of pucks bouncing, and that's what you look at when the ice is bad.
Shovel shot, and that grabbed by Thomas off the stick of Eric Brewer, and a little extra between Malone and Chara.
Well, Chara tried to bait him into that, and then he gets a little help as the linesman holds him up. But Chara tried to bait Malone into taking a penalty. You watch here, watch what, right there, kind of goes after him, tries to draw something. Malone does a nice job keeping his hands down and not taking a penalty.
Seen Ryan Malone go to the front of that. He missed the opportunity a little bit earlier from Simon Gagné. I thought he was outstanding in that 4-0 sweep of the Washington Capitals, doing all the little things and going to the net. You keep going to those areas in front, something good's going to happen.
Father Greg, one of the all-time great scorers with the Pittsburgh Penguins, a team that seems to always have a lot of great scorers, don't they? Puck taken to the outside now, and Recchi puts it into the catching glove of Smith.
By the way, Dana Tyrell has left the Tampa Bay bench. Remember, he's been out a long, long time with a bad ankle. And he tripped down high in the slot and got up limping, limped right past me, went to the bench for a while, and then headed to the locker room. So that man right there, Guy Boucher, the head coach of Tampa Bay, is one forward short. Which I don't think bothers him all that much. He's been used to playing 11 forwards most of the regular season.
Oh, well, you're right. Usually seven defense. Randy Jones was the seventh defenseman early in this series. Nice work there by St. Louis. Backhander off of Thomas, but he's got it sealed up. And play is stopped, and the scoreboard remains 3-3.
We talk about faceoffs, but Vinny LeCavalier and Marty St. Louis. Now, here's St. Louis. LeCavalier, what is he doing? He's got this puck on his forehand, so he's going to shoot it out in this area off the draw. Right now, this is a confidence team. This is a very confident team when you're trying to go ahead and shoot the puck almost into the opposition. With LeCavalier and St. Louis, and it's just pretty much there's eye contact. And when the opportunity presents itself to take a chance like that, you go for it. And that's a heads-up play by two veteran guys 180 feet away from Tim Thomas.
Oh, a close feed, and he got it there, didn't he? It's knocked down in front as they battled for it. Two times, St. Louis tried to reach Purcell, and the second time he did for the shot.
That was another set play. St. Louis moved Purcell to the slot before the faceoff.
Shot deflected off a foot in front. And then the puck had gone off a high stick, but play continued there because it was possession by the opposition and then stashed back down again by Horton. Will it be icing? Yes, it will.
Now, right before the faceoff, Purcell was lined up on the board. St. Louis moved him over. Now, watch what St. Louis does. That's Purcell there. Thank you, Eddie. Here comes St. Louis. A little drop pass to Purcell right there. And the shot gets deflected before it goes there. But, Eddie, you're right. I mean, this Tampa Bay team, everything is, they just have a lot more life.
It's just, we've seen it in this series. We talked about it in the open. Game one, three goals for Tampa Bay. In 85 seconds, game two, period two, a five-goal second period for the Boston Bruins. And here you got Tampa scoring three in just under 4 minutes.
Here's Downey pulling. Downey wants to shoot, and that one was blocked by Seidenberg, who got in the way of that Purcell try a moment ago.
Good play there by Nathan Horton defensively.
Here's Horton with it, moving on, and it's chased right off. Good, effective play there, and bouncing down to the ice, Downey. And what do we have?
Both of them.
Horton gets right near the hunched over Downey.
I think they're both going.
I think they're giving Downey an unsportsmanlike conduct for diving. He made a very good defensive play.
Did he grab his stick here, Joe,
Let's
at all?
See what happens. He goes down, and then he gets right back up. So the initial call was made. I think the second part of this is embellishment. We'll see. There's Horton after he had the puck knocked away from him by Downey.
Yeah, look at Horton looking at the referee right away, and that's Tim Peel. And Downey's hurt. And Downey is shaken up. I mean, he hit those boards violently after the hit by Nathan Horton. I don't know if he ends up hitting his head on the dasher in between the glass and the boards. Just above that, but he goes head first.
I was surprised he got up so quickly here, though.
Let's take a listen. and he never moved his feet after that. So you get 4-on-4 hockey here for a couple of minutes. Adam Hall is serving the penalty for Steve Downey.
Diving on Downey. Boarding on Horton. Four aside.
I'm still a believer if you dive, you should negate the initial penalty. That's the way you'll get rid of it.
Seidenberg tried to drag it along, could not. Hammered into Clark. Two-a-side battle. Exciting game 77 of the Stanley Cup playoffs. That is the fifth diving call of the entire playoffs. Right out in front it comes. But I like your idea. If somebody dives, then that negates the first one, and so you still have a power play. This time, it's even strength, though short, and we have an icing. 1:49 to go, second period, 3-3 tie. You presented that idea 2 years ago on one of our shows. I liked it then, but obviously the Board of Governors and the GMs did not. So an offensive zone faceoff. If you're Boston, how do you want to stabilize this?
Well, knowing Tampa Bay, with the momentum and the aggression they play with, anytime their defensemen get the puck, they're looking to just throw it straight ahead. So I think if you're Boston, make sure you keep yourself in between the Tampa Bay forwards and Tim Thomas.
To the outside lead, Boychuk, a shot covered by Smith. He has been perfect and continues to be.
Well, Tyler Seguin getting an opportunity in a 4-on-4 situation. Look at the open ice to the left. Beautiful pass by Rich Beverly and Johnny Boychuk. Probably a little bit more time on this opportunity, but he tried to one time it. Good positioning there by Mike Smith, moving right to left, coming out. And Victor Hedman does a good job on Tyler Seguin, not allowing him to get to the front of net to maybe possibly screen that man right there.
Well, Eddie, you talked about before, he was anticipating the shoot-ins by the Bruins. This time, his anticipation was perfect on the setup.
What do you think they're talking about there?
Responsibilities off the faceoff with Krejci getting thrown out. And that's a good job there by Krejci to help the youngster out in this 4-on-4 situation.
By the way, guys, a thing to remember now, Tampa is now down.
Oh, with the disappearance of Downey, right.
Correct.
Well, get your gear on.
Who are you talking to?
You. You're the closest guy down there.
International Falls, Minnesota, I think. Here's Seguin, a shot turned aside by Smith. Here comes LeCavalier, drifting on, fakes the drive. He's got Purcell nearby, slams on the brakes. Wanted to jab it to the point, kept alive neatly there by Lundin. But it's on a delayed offside, and now that offside will be called. I'm sorry, I thought he had held it. So 23 seconds remaining on the coincidental penalties. 58 and change remaining in the second period.
And I think to the points that you both were making about now down to 10 forwards, shift lengths become so important. The length, short shifts, 15, 20 seconds, if that's all. I mean, really, you shouldn't be going anything more than 25. If you're sustained pressure offensively, maybe you stay out a little longer, but it's pretty much with 10 forwards, it's up and down and off.
Now, we talked about the ice a little bit. That has held up pretty well, but it is warm in this building.
Walk back ahead by Dominic Moore. Shakes away from one. Backhander in front. Glanced off Thomas. Forced along, and that was a rather unhealthy high hit there coming from Olin, but not callable. Back ahead now comes Bergenheim, and that forced away.
Well, the hands were up on Olin. He got lucky there.
Barrett's lost it. Jabbed into Thomas by Dominic Moore. Carried right back up the wing. It's becoming a little helter-skelter here. Dragged on by Ryder off the outside of the cage. Puck led up the boards. The Lightning start back. Mike Smith is 13 for 13 in shots and saves this period. Along with this one, forced around behind was Brewer. Brewer circles now in the last eight of the period. Threw it in front. Stick bond. Puck dragged along now and jabbed at by Adam Hall. Around again it is Moore. 2 seconds and one. That'll do it. They pop open the three-ring binder and put in the script of the second period after it's taken place. We don't do them in advance. That means the third period's going to be a lot of fun. Coming up in the Discover Intermission Report, Mike Milbury, Liam McHugh with highlights and insights from our game so far. And then we'll preview tomorrow's game four between the Canucks and the Sharks. That's ahead on the Discover Intermission Report. Purcell from Gagne at 6:55. Purcell from Oland and LeCavalier at 7:58. Bergenheim from Moore at 10:53. All even up, three apiece after two. To the NHL Stanley Cup playoffs on NBC, presented by Geico. No carryover penalties nor power plays as we get into the third. There is carryover discussion.
Tim Peel doing a good job there talking with Guy Boucher, the head coach of the Lightning.
The man who came on in relief. The man who has played every minute. Mike Smith at one end, Tim Thomas at the other. The return of Steve Downey is uncertain. And the same can be said for Dana Tyrell. So it is 10 forwards for now. And six defensemen for Guy Boucher's Lightning. Brought ahead by Recchi. Hurried shot by Patrice Bergeron is deflected up into the mesh out of play. So 15 gone here in the third.
A good quick passing by the Boston Bruins out of their zone. The quick entry. Nice little play there by Mark Recchi to get the puck to Patrice Bergeron to force the puck towards Mike Smith.
Every draw of significance. Bergeron has not had the ringing success that he had the other day. 3-for-6 in the first, 3-for-7 in the second. Still, that's right around 50%, and overall he normally goes into the 60s.
But 66% for Tampa in this game. Another reversal.
Kind of like game one. Went the other way for the Bruins in two and three.
Tampa Bay was 61% in game one.
The Lightning on the attack. Nate Thompson moves in the trapezoid. Tim Thomas laid it ahead. Kareem back up the boards. Brad Marchand watches this one.
Good finish check there by Bergenheim on Andrew Ferentz.
Nudged right back on again and moving on to San Luis. It came right in on goal off the defense and is held by Thomas. Let's go inside the glass with Joe.
Well, in the first intermission, the fiery head coach of Tampa Bay, Guy Boucher, in a very calm way told his team, you're playing nervous. Relax and let's get aggressive. And boy, did they ever get aggressive in the second period. They came out, they looked like a different team. They got their forecheck going. They caused turnovers. They had efforts like this by Bergenheim and the rest of the team. And by playing aggressively, they got back in the game.
This is Zdeno Chara emerging from a rather aggressive play himself. And then off Seidenberg, but trouble there. Knifed around in front. Reaching was Thomas. And a wraparound attempt and another try. And it went wide. Good start for the Lightning here. Thrown right back along by Brewer and cut off and steered back further. Eric Brewer holds it there, connects back on with San Luis, drops it in, hoping for LeCavalier, Chara on him. Closed off, and the third man with Seidenberg to take it and lay it along to Milan Lucic. The big aggressive winger able to lug it out to center and move on. Plays it off the boards, moves for it, threw one across the net mouth wide that came back ahead for the carry back on. Marching right back ahead with it, Stamkos pulled the trigger on a shot, slithered right in front, and is grabbed there before it got to Thomas by Boychuk. And Boychuk fed one that shanked out to center and is turned right back in. Here comes a chance now for Malone moving in. Oh, it wouldn't go. Malone again, banks one. Thomas is spread eagle, post to post, and play is stopped, and Thomas is still lying there.
Well, Malone started this play just outside the blue line by getting it in, and then he just follows it up. There it is. And he beats everybody to the loose puck, and now he uses that great size and strength. Thomas with one excellent save. Malone wouldn't quit on the play and then tried to bank it in, but here it is again. And Thomas with the stick. Nice job with the stick, and then takes away everything down low. He lays across the crease. There was no place to go as Malone tried to bank it in.
Remember, Ryan Malone had a breakaway in game two. He went to the same move, forehand, backhand. In that game, he tried to hold on to a second longer. This one, he tried to beat Thomas while he was in between. Great effort. And right before that, Milan Lucic almost made the same type play where he passed the puck to himself and went in. So good efforts by Lucic and Malone.
Tyler Seguin had that one knocked away. Stamkos tries to control. Ferentz said no. Stamkos peels off at center and laid it on back. Marc-Andre Bergeron ahead for Bergenheim. And it's flexed back in, and Andrew Ferentz, who was with Calgary, playing against Tampa Bay in 04 when they went to the seventh game of the Stanley Cup final, and Tampa Bay won. This is held and laid on back away from McQuaid. One-time drive is canceled out by Olin. Thompson lugs it ahead. Here's Thompson trying to get by. No, says McQuaid. Ferentz moves in on Bergenheim. Puck yanked off the back of the cage, and sitting down is Moore. The puck came near him. It's Bergenheim trying to jam one, and that one bounced aside as Thomas held that side of the net, and McQuaid is able to hold. That one speared along and thrown further by Seguin. He comes to the bench for an obedient change of lines. 3 minutes into the third, game tied at three. Right back on comes San Luis. San Luis fed one that's poked away, and a nice dive by Patrice Bergeron. Bergeron got in the way of that one, is able to walk it back in. Bergeron fights his way free from his knees, saw that one go to the corner where they jostle for it there. Taken back up by Tampa Bay. Lightning connect back ahead, and it's Purcell bringing it on. Purcell holds and shoots one, save made by Thomas. Large rebound, but it's laid back out again by Bergeron. Right across by Lundin. Marc-Andre Bergeron, no relation, goes circle to circle with this over to Lundin. Up the wing, Gagne, and out of play. The Stanley Cup playoffs continue tomorrow on NBC as the Canucks take on the Sharks in a pivotal game four. Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico tomorrow, 3 Eastern, only on NBC. Dave Strader, Brian Engblom, Darren Pang will be at the tank yet again.
5-0 in shots, favor of the Lightning here in the third.
A twisting play by Paille, escapes at center. Falling was Bergeron, and along with it comes Gregory Campbell. Bergeron knifed that pass out of the air. Worked for it by Peverly, knifed to the corner and after it, and sweeping it along was Campbell, and it went out of play.
This line's been good for Boston here this afternoon. Not a lot of ice time for Campbell, Peverly, and Paille, but they've been effective. And that's what you need. You need your fourth line to go out there and not kill minutes, but you want to have quality minutes and not defend. You want to play in the offensive zone. It's no fun defending. It's tiring, and you know, you want to gain the confidence of your coach. And when you play in the offensive zone, you're going to earn that opportunity.
Brought on by Brett Clark. Clark holds and shoots one that's carefully grabbed and held by Tim Thomas. Cops are cracking down on unbuckled drivers all across the country. If you don't use your seatbelt, you'll get stuck with a ticket. Click it or ticket. This message is brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration.
I think as well, you're the Boston Bruins. You know that the Tampa Bay Lightning are short forwards. From 12 to 10, Tyrell, Downey, not sure if they're going to be able to come back. And now there's Tyrell. So he just came back to the bench, and now he's on the ice. There he is. So yeah. Now they're up to 11.
He was questionable right. In between periods.
So the aspect of finishing all your checks on the fourth for Tampa Bay if you're Boston.
Wear them down physically even more.
Absolutely.
Thrown by Brewer, collared and started back out again by Peverly. One hands it ahead. Fought at there. Poked around behind, I beg your pardon, that was Krejci that did that. 46, not 49. This punch back out again, and after it is Adam Hall. Watched there by Ferentz. Hall delays, and the Michigan Stater put it to the outside where Thomas could block it aside, and Krejci controls there. So it is Ferentz. A little under 5 minutes played. A little more careful here in the third, as I guess you'd expect. A lot at stake. Oh, a giveaway, and Lucic pushed one off of Smith. My. Back on out. It is brought by Bergenheim, holding to the outside, sent it on back, and Stamkos whistled one wide. Gathered in by Patrice Bergeron, heads it on now to Lucic. He's been a pretty powerful forward in this series. Drops it back, trying to pull the trigger, was Recchi, could not. Thrown back across for the advance out by Moore. Grabbed by Seidenberg, and he spins it across to Big Zdeno Chara. Led ahead to Mark Recchi, 43 years of age, plops it right back in. Stopped by Smith, reversed back up the boards. Recchi moves for it, punched away from him by Purcell, who has two of the three Lightning goals. sing-song chant of Let's Go Lightning here. This is handed to Chara. Big Slovakian-born defenseman laid it ahead, and it's filtered back in, but into a glove. Marc-Andre Bergeron gave it on a cross, and this is steered ahead for the carry-on by Stanley. Stanley delays, lays it on back. Bergeron there, shooting, save! Thomas, and he covers.
Well, nice outlet pass there by the Tampa Bay Lightning. LeCavalier, the St. Louis, and Marc-Andre Bergeron, who started that play, as you mentioned, Doc, by grabbing that puck in midair and going D to D.
Well, and just part of that, remember, this has been a game where we've seen a lot of turnovers. Goals scored off turnovers, and Lucic nearly gave the Bruins a lead on that turnover.
Important draw collared by the Bruins. That was Gregory Campbell dueling that time with Vincent LeCavalier. But icing is called, so back it will come.
Let's show a real good play by Andrew Ferentz. We've got a lot of young defensemen out there to watch our games. Look at his positioning. Stop it right here. Look at where his stick is. It's out. Stick on puck, stick on stick, and he keeps Adam Hall to the outside. Outstanding job. Not two hands, one hand. You gain a lot more space if you have one hand on the stick, and that's the way that you play a one-on-one situation. Keep them to the outside, stick on the ice, make life difficult for that forward.
Another tie-up. Campbell kneels down, puck pops free. Bruins have it again. Chara tried to skyhook one ahead. It slid across the Bruins in the midst of a change. Fresh to play it now, but unable to swagger away was Lucic. It's given on to Purcell. Backhander speared away by the goal stick held by Thomas. Krejci able to drop it back off the boards for the carry ahead. Boychuk fired it back in. It eluded the reach of Smith. Chipped on back to the point, and it skipped the center where Boychuk just grubs it back along. The late offside is now wiped. 6.5 gone in the third. This is Purcell with it. Shooting, and it went wide. Rebound swung in front off a stick. Back to Hedman, and that one was blocked in front. Oh, who took that one?
Taberle.
And he wanted to go to the bench. He's got to stay out now. This is Malone. Backhands one in front. Gagne scores! We've talked about them all game long. Both teams, it seems like as soon as they turn the puck over, it ends up in their net. Ryan Malone's been all over the place in this game, hasn't he? In the middle of everything.
He has been outstanding. What a great pass on the backhand. And that quick shot, the quick stick of Simon Gagne.
Rolled in by McQuaid, hammers into Clark. Peeling off with it is Thompson. Meanwhile, McQuaid and Clark still tied up behind, so a forward has to drop back defensively. This one came back in, and it is fed. Oh, and fanning on the centering pass was Thompson. This is held by Marc-Andre Bergeron, tipped onto the back. Little helter-skelter right now. Bounced off the stick of Adam Hall to the corner. Battled for by Thompson and by Ferentz. Reaching in is Michael Ryder. Freed it to the half boards. Another scrum for it there. And Ferentz can now emerge as the Lightning are changing. Uncontested for the blast in from center. The backhand grab by Mike Smith. The NHL Stanley Cup playoffs on NBC presented by Geico.
What's all this? Big news. We have another way to help you save.
Oh, really? How?
By bundling. If you get your homeowners and auto insurance together, we give you even more savings.
Ooh.
Big bundle. Home and auto together. It's like peanut butter and jelly.
Oh, or like burgers and fries.
Or pickles and ice cream. Unicorns and glitter. No.
Bundling to save you more. Now that's Progressive. Call or click today. LensCrafters has the styles you love.
at the LensCrafter Style Event. Save up to 50% on eyeglasses and sunglasses made with your prescription. Hurry in. LensCrafters.
If you have the audacity to believe that a financial advisor should look you in the eye when the topic is your money,
join the nearly 7 million investors who think like you do. FaceTime and ThinkTime make a difference. At Edward Jones, it's how we make sense of investing. Whether you're bringing the players or you're bringing the arena, Honda Trucks.
Well, there's Milan Lucic. He's going for this puck. Now watch what ends up happening. He takes a quick look. Stop it right here. Look at all this ice he has to take. But what he doesn't see is this man right here, which is Ryan Malone. Move your feet. And I think Milan Lucic has been very, very good in this series. And it's a simple play. I know what he's trying to do. He's trying to force the puck. But if you're going to go through the middle of the ice, you better be 110% sure if it's along the ice. Just keep moving your feet. Worst thing you do, move it up the boards.
Boychuk moves it ahead. Gave it over for Ferentz to turn. Shakes one in front. It rattled around, and Smith has this one too.
This is really the first time we've seen the Boston Bruins around Mike Smith. Everything has been from the outside, not a lot of net crashing, not a lot of closeness by the Boston Bruins forwards around the large goaltender for Tampa Bay.
Now the other thing is that Tampa's defense hasn't had nearly the pressure on them that they had in the first period. And this Boston team came out forechecking, causing turnovers, and that led to obviously their goals. Haven't seen much of that since the first.
Thrown along and hit was Olin. Hold free for Lightning possession. Stamkos led it ahead. Played back on. Oh, and what a collision there between Malone. Has a chance for Stamkos. Malone and Boychuk. Controlled by the Bruins, who are down by one in the game with 11 and three quarter minutes to play.
And Malone got his head up just before the hit and was able to avoid most of it.
Marchand threw it across the net, mouth wide. Fresh from the bench, it's Seidenberg moving in. Hit by Hedman. Puck escaped the other way. Recchi played it up. Chara played it back. Around it comes to Seidenberg again. Grabbed and thrown right back to the point again by Brad Marchand, and it is Chara flipping one that's held by Smith.
Well, this Tampa Bay team started to get aggressive in the second period. They've continued that here in the first period. Look how they just attack the net. Not one player, not two, three. They get support to the net, and eventually it all pays off as Simone Gagné, after the brilliant feed by Ryan Malone, gives Tampa Bay a 4-3 lead. Four consecutive goals.
You're not kidding, Joe. Watching that replay again with Ryan Malone, two Boston Bruins players really in perfect position. And he makes that backhand pass right on the take, and Gagné never has to break stride at all.
Chara floats one in, blocked aside by Smith, who reaches out and touched it around behind further. Boy, he's got a long reach too, doesn't he? Here's Chara with this one, shooting, and that one rattled wide. Played along again by Krejci. Boston starting to get some territorial work done here. This one laid along for San Luis, who can step back out. Nearing the halfway point of the third, into the catching glove of Thomas it goes. Pursuing him is Purcell, the puck thrown away and taken along by Seidenberg.
You wonder why the referee didn't blow the whistle.
For a frozen puck?
Yeah.
Pitched ahead. Had he thrown it ahead, there could have been a penalty call, too, for advancing the puck. They don't like goaltenders to do that or just about anything else but stop the puck. Patrolling on this one is Lundin. 10:22 to go. Puck played along by Adam Hall. Couldn't get by Ryder. Puck dropped right back ahead again and corralled by Marc-Andre Bergeron. Head back up for Adam Hall to connect across. Shaken right back to him, and Hall, a backhander that went wide. Eludes the reach of Bergenheim. Played back out and roughed up a little bit was Kelly. Bergeron connected across. Mike Lundin spirited it back in off of Adam Hall.
Nice back check there by Dominic Moore. That back pressure on Chris Kelly just shut it right off, and the puck ends up back in the Boston zone.
And very short shift by Tampa.
Let's go Bolts is the chant. They want to see a win. They want to see another game six that will be assured if they get the win and the series is tied. Bank back off the boards. Reached for by Bergeron, sent behind by Ryder. 9.5 to go in the third. Bruins can't get in. Shaken right back along by Hedman. How the complexion changes. Guilty of a couple of big gaffes in the first. But he has gotten his confidence back seemingly here as the game's gone on. Drilled back in by McQuaid. Rattled on around further and is punted on by Bergeron to the corner. Patrice Bergeron of the Bruins. Able to get this and wanted to swing it back to the point, but that one cut. Sent back across by Gagne. Followed up now by Stamkos. And Stamkos wheels to the outside. Matched there by Ferentz. Centering pass carefully blocked by McQuaid. And then Patrice Bergeron couldn't filter it through. Ferentz will have to try again, and this time they do it.
A little different look here on this line with Bergeron and Recchi. Don't see Brad Marchand. It was Peverly that took the spot of Marchand on that last shift.
Lightning back to the attack again. Adam Hall quickly right out there again, and then a shoulder by Bergenheim and a feed in front that bounced around and can be carried right back out again by Seidenberg. Well-used defenseman fires it right back in again. Taken on now by Nathan Horton and given to the back. Chara led it across. Seidenberg with it there. Back to Chara. One-time drive. Grabbed and held by Smith.
Edmunds.com says that Lexus holds its value better than any other luxury brand. IntelliChoice proclaims that Lexus has the best overall value of any brand. And J.D. Power and Associates ranks Lexus the highest in customer satisfaction. No wonder more people have chosen Lexus over any other luxury brand 11 years in a row. See your Lexus dealer.
On training days,
I need the fuel to get me ahead of the pack.
Start with a breakfast that can't be beat.
Like the protein-packed Sunrise Subway Melt. Try it with juicy tomatoes, fresh toasted on flatbread.
Trying to stay on track?
You gotta eat the best.
Like the Orchard Chicken Salad Sub. Taste terrific chicken with apples, tangy cranberries, and crunchalicious celery on freshly baked bread.
Subway, the official training restaurant of Apollo Ono.
Blake Griffin.
Nasty Lucan.
And athletes everywhere.
His words carry weight that would break a less interesting man's jaw. He's won trophies for his game face alone. He bowls overhand. He is the most interesting man in the world.
I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer Dos Equis. Stay thirsty, my friends.
Tomorrow, Ryan Kesler and the Sedin brothers lead the Vancouver Canucks into the Shark Tank to take on San Jose. Score! The Stanley Cup Playoffs, tomorrow 3 Eastern on NBC.
Mike Smith played junior hockey in Kingston and Sudbury. He has been perfect this afternoon. Played in the ECHL in Lexington, in Utah. In Houston, in Dallas with the Stars, and in Iowa. In Lexington, he saw a lot of great horses, I'm sure, which you'll see later on today at the Preakness. But has he ever been strong in two relief appearances? Unblemished. Across it comes to Char, shooting one that's blocked aside and lifted back out the center.
Dominic Moore.
Rattled around and it took a crazy bounce and is turned over to LeCavalier and turned aside by Thomas. And then LeCavalier again and that one blocked by a couple of Bruins. Shaken back in is trying to get to that one was Krejci. Krejci stood up his man there and that was Olin. Olin and Brewer are always out there seemingly against these guys. That one bounced back to center and can be brought ahead by Nate Thompson. Chara trying to match him there. And help came from Sagan, but he pulled away from him. St. Louis moves in, shoots one. Save made by Thomas and a cover.
Well, beautiful move there by Nate Thompson. Straight down the boards. He pulls up. And you like to see Tyler Sagan. He'll come to the right part of your screen. You like to see him go through his hands and his body. Doesn't have to be a big hit, but just go through him so he's not allowed to make that play. St. Louis comes in, fakes the shot. Thomas holds his ground. St. Louis didn't not only have to worry about the shot and the defenseman sliding, but also that stick that was on the ice to make sure he got around that and got the puck to the net.
That's what they've worked on all season long with Sagan, is watching a lot of film on how to learn to be a better defensive player. No question about his offense.
Marc-Andre Bergeron's shot was sent aside by Thomas. Poked along in traffic. Nate Thompson pulls it free, gives it across to St. Louis. Dropped it on now for the carry by Hall. Here's Hall with a shot. Save Thomas. Rebound. Oh, and a defensive job done there by Ryder and by Boychuk, or it would have been 5-3 likely. Down for an icing touch-up. Offensive zone face-off to come near Tim Thomas.
Right through the neutral zone. Quick play. St. Louis, beautiful little pass to use the boards. Adam Hall with the shot and then the opportunity for Nate Thompson. You called it, Doc. The quick stick of Michael Ryder right there. Clears it into the corner.
And he came over to the bench to Adam Hall and gave him a little tap to St. Louis. He said, almost, almost.
Here is Chris Kelly. Pulled and shot back into the catching glove of Smith, and he's just going to wait on this one. All rookie team in 2007 in this National Hockey League when he was property of the Dallas Stars. Only Verizon gives you more Stanley Cup playoff hockey than ever before with the NHL Game Center Premium app. Text NHL to 86003 to download now.
Fourth shot on goal of the period. That last opportunity from way out by Tyler Seguin. Tampa Bay 12 in this third period.
Waved out is Stamkos. So in comes Malone to test with Patrice Bergeron. Sent away from Marchand. Drubbed on by Olin and played back out again by Gagne, who stacks up as a hero of this one. If it doesn't change. 6:35 to go. The blast back in by Adam McQuaid. But it wound up going out of play. And a neutralized faceoff to result from that.
Well, they mentioned there a shift to go where the line changing going on for the Boston Bruins and Claude Julien changing some of the parts and pieces of particular lines. Mark Recchi was out there the shift before with Bergeron and Pemberley. Now it's Marchand with an opportunity. Try to generate and sustain a lot more if you're the Boston Bruins offensively here in the third, down by one.
Boy, the helmets really go into one another when you bend down to take a faceoff, don't they? And that is causing Bergeron to be out.
Causing Le Cavalier to get mad.
Anger is not in the rule book. It's fine.
Not less of that when players didn't wear helmets.
Smith gave it up to Marchand. Front in front, they battled for it, and it careened in quickly on Smith, who hangs on.
Oh, what an opportunity. Again, goaltender playing the puck around the boards, and a Patrice Bergeron with the opportunity right there. And Mike Smith's able to get back in. But Brad Marchand does a nice job of cutting off that passing angle.
Another large faceoff. Off the tie-up, won by the Bruins, on back to Chara, lifts one that's knifed down, and battled for, gotten by Bergeron, save made by Smith!
Joe, you had the best angle. At this opportunity, it looked like there was some room on the glove side for Bergeron.
It was just great work, not giving up. And Smith came over, tried to come out a little bit to cut down the angle. And for Bergeron, though, he knew he had to get the shot off quickly. So I'm not sure he had enough time to look up and see that little bit of room on the short side.
Smith, the 29-year-old native of Kingston, Ontario, 6'4", 215 pounds, a large guy. In the goal crease for the Tampa Bay Lightning. Brought ahead now by Stamkos. Shoveled it back in. Boychuk reached it, couldn't clear it. The two of them waltz to the corner. Played back along by Moore. Reaching in further is Mark Recchi. Out of a five-man scrum at Stamkos. Shakes around behind. Led one on for Olin. Punched it around behind as we're down to the last 5:55 of the third. At one time it was 3-0 Bruins. in the second. Three goals in less than 4 minutes for the Lightning. And in the third, Gagne for Malone at 6:54 to break the tie. Lob back in yet again. Brewer couldn't get to that one. Marchand could. Able to stumble by and get possession back. Marchand forced to the outside. Laid it on back to Ferentz. Here's Ferentz firing! And that one went wide, tumbling down to the ice. In front was Krejci.
That was Mike Smith that took his stick and tripped up. I believe it was Rich Peverly standing right in front of the net.
Pretty interesting. This is carried back ahead. This is Milan Lucic. Has Krejci moving ahead with him. Lucic brought it in. Oh, he was taken with authority by Brett Clark. Clark reaching in for that one is able to slip it back along, hoping for Gagne. McQuaid hanged his way back in, but it's taken by Hedman. Oh, and he's hit by Lucic. Now it's Thompson going one-on-one with Ferentz. Thompson pulls. Ferentz able to wrestle him off. And Thompson behind. Oh, and a big hit that was coming from Ferentz, but it looked like it got more of Horton than anyone else. Horton moves in, tries to jab it up the boards for possession. Can't do it yet. Peeled off now by Lucic and led back across. Krejci delays, puts it on the stick of Lucic, comes to the bench for a change, and so the Lightning are able to shift it right back. Purcell dropped it off, carried on by San Luis. Le Cavalier breaking, thrown into the catching glove of Tim Thomas. 21,216, thrilling to this contest. We hope you are. Oh my.
Them Rocket, you got this.
Here we go.
It's the sure sign of a good time. The just right taste of Bud Light. Here we go.
You gotta admit, it was a heck of a catch.
Got this one, old man.
For drivers who want to get the most out of their cars, it's Bridgestone or nothing.
If you don't have an iPhone, you don't have the Retina display, the highest resolution screen on any phone. So movies aren't this dramatic. Maps aren't this clear. Emails aren't this detailed. And memories aren't this memorable. Yep, if you don't have an iPhone, well, you don't have an iPhone.
From Derby Long Shot,
Animal Kingdom, to win the Derby!
To Britney's favorite, Animal Kingdom runs for history and a chance at the elusive Triple Crown at the Preakness Stakes, next only on NBC.
Well, here's that opportunity for the Boston Bruins with the shot on goal. Watch it, look part of your screen. It's David Krejci in front of them. There's that trip I talked about on Mike Smith. No call. And don't forget, the Preakness Stakes is coming up right after this game here in Tampa.
Wave down to the faceoff is Le Cavalier. Purcell comes in to draw. Rich Peverly goes against him. One through the legs by Peverly. Banked back off the glass. Just away from Kelly. Played by Clark. Former Hershey Bear able to accelerate back to center ice for these Lightning. Punched a pass ahead that escaped off San Luis and Chara. And then is held by Seidenberg. Connects to Chara. The shot leader for the Bruins with 10. Having some trouble with Purcell's checking. Scaling it behind is Sagan. And it's taken by Seidenberg. Leads it back the other way. Pass chipped ahead. Sagan dropped it back in and charged in after it. Smith able to foist it away. Lobbed back on by Hedman. Grabbed down and played by Ryder. Spirited right back around near Sagan. Coming by though is Clark. Scrapped for right out in front, and Le Cavalier scooped it on for Hall. Held by Seidenberg. Right back along for Hedman again. Hedman banked it ahead. Hall tried to slip it through. Got it as far as center. Chopped back in. Delayed offside is wiped. 3:30 to go. Caverly back to handle this one. Hall the forechecker for Tampa Bay. That one went off of Bergenheim and down. This is Olin having trouble with the Bruins forecheck. Up the boards, Caberle, and that one blocked down. Settled down there by Malone, jabbed it off the stick of Dominic Moore. Trying to get further with it, it's Bergenheim, no luck there. And Boychuk is shaken up after trying to apply that big hit to Bergenheim.
Yeah, it was the stick of Bergenheim that got him.
Walk back ahead now by Marchand, and a shot deflected across and tucked to the front of the net. But it couldn't be worked further as Recchi had a try. Then around in front, oh, Bergeron, a shot that was wide at the short side, and Kareem back to center.
For Boston now, when the puck's in the offensive zone, the defenseman got to pinch in to keep plays alive.
It is Caberle ahead. Reconnects up that side, and it's brought on now by Krejci, and a shot is snuffed down. Krejci going to work further as the Bruins continue their change from the bench. Grubbed on back to center and down. Will it be icing? The race on. McQuaid gets in there, and icing is called with 2:19 to go. Third period. Offensive zone faceoff for Boston, trailing by one.
Well, there's Sean Bergenheim. He anticipates, sees Johnny Boychuk, and he kind of avoids him with his left arm, but then the stick ends up catching Boychuk. Almost a clothesline effect as Boychuk misses the majority of Bergenheim.
Timeout, Tampa. Good timeout by Guy Boucher. That group that's on the ice for them, they had come over by the bench. They were tired. Guy Boucher noticed that, took his time, waited for everybody to get set before he used his timeout.
Question one, at what time do you get it, six attackers out there for Boston if the score doesn't change?
Well, I think that you have to look at if you have sustained pressure or not. I don't think that you go any earlier than maybe a minute and 15, a minute and 10 to get Thomas to the bench for the extra attacker. You know, puck possession and where the puck is on the ice has, you know, the biggest determining factor of that.
And as a coach, I always marvel at how they can time down the shifts to have the guys they absolutely want to have out there for that period of time.
That was a big factor too in game 7 between San Jose and Detroit when we were doing that game where Mike Babcock had his big guys out there early and they couldn't finish the game because they were out there for almost a minute and a half before.
And we're short by two guys right. From the time the game started to the game ended. So here's Ferentz sending one past Ryder. Still in the cage, by the way, is Thomas. This one skipped along and is thrown, but it ricocheted around behind. Horton moving in for that one, taken by Michael Ryder. Ryder angled it to the back, and Ferentz has it. Shooting one, tip right near the goal, and Smith able to grab it. Oh, Horton deflected that one, and Smith was able to hang on.
Boy, what a great redirect by Nathan Horton in front of the net. Low to high, Michael Ryder gets his puck to Andy Ferentz. Look at Nathan Horton. He gets there, and now he stops it for, watch the redirect. That shot was at least 3 feet off the net, and Horton with the redirect, and what a stop by Mike Smith. Boy, there was a little bit of room under, or in between the pad and the post of Mike Smith. We should get a real good look at this.
Boy, that's a great save.
Yeah, almost
that's
looks
a
like
heck
it's
of a
the
save.
Toe or the post, one of the two.
Maybe both.
Yeah.
And for Guy Boucher, he's got three center icemen on the ice right now as his faceoff is in their zone.
I think the situation room in Toronto is making sure that that puck did not cross the goal line off that redirect by Nathan Horton.
It's all a product, to be absolutely sure. Two full decades the league has been doing this. To get it right. It remains 4-3, 1:50 to go. Net still occupied at the other end by Tim Thomas. Chipped around behind. It's thrown on by Hedman. Back up the boards, Le Cavalier. Cannot clear out just yet. Battled for there. Reached by Horton. Horton spins it back along. Ryder can't get there. Hedman can, but Ryder then crosses him. Reaching in for it was Peverly, and squibbed around behind. Dominic Moore, nice shuffle along the board, but pinching in was Chara. Play still alive for the Bruins, but it squibbed back out, and so Ryder will go back nearing the hash marks and just holding his pose is Tim Thomas, as we're down to that time that Eddie mentioned. A minute 15, and there he heads to the bench. Craig back in by Seidenberg. Net empty at the other end. It's taken by Recchi. Angles it on to the back for Seidenberg. Whips it across to Chara. Chara had trouble setting it up and then was able to give it on Bergeron, and it's thrown in front, and that one spiked to the glass. Played back near the half boards and grabbed off and hoisted on back to center ice and headed to the bench, and a change after doing that is Olin. Now Seidenberg laid it on across to Chara, 47 to go. Rips it back in. Gotten by Hedman. Hedman able to hoist it back along, and it is out to center. Two on one, net empty across to Gagne, to St. Louis.
Finds St. Louis with the pass to make it 5-3.
Well, watch what happens. Stop it here. Look at Victor Hedman. He's already inside his own zone. He's able to get this puck before Boston's able to get any kind of sustained forecheck. Chara shoots it in, and Hedman takes one strike, gets it, airmails it, puck in the back of the net.
Nate Thompson peels off with this one. Led it to the back to Hedman. Around behind, taken by Stamkos. Ferentz on him, forearm shiver, 20 to go. Back up the boards, Hedman a shot, and it whistled wide. A rallying group of Lightning, and a goaltender who has still not given up any goals in two playoff appearances. They'll celebrate the end. Ovation from 21,000 watching here today, and the team goes to center ice to salute the fans. And the question is, Mike Smith again?
You might have to think about it.